In this section, we will see the ensemble methods. So, ensemble methods are also called as meta algorithms, which combines the several machine learning techniques into one predictive model. And while we are combining the various machine learning techniques so that we can do the particular meta algorithm combination, and we are designing the particular model in order to decrease the variance, which is called as bagging, bias, that which is called as boosting, and for improving the predictions, which is called as stacking. So, bagging means what? We will start, we will see first the basic thing, that ensemble methods combines several decision trees, and that are combination of several decision trees has been done so that we can produce the better predictive performance than utilizing the single decision tree. The main principle behind the ensemble model is that a group of weak learners come together to form a strong learner. Generally, this particular funda we use in our daily life, that if we want to be a strong person, then the group of weak persons can work together and be strong. Same way, the principle ensemble methods, so that the group of weak can come together and form the strong. Basically, they are divided into two groups, that is sequential ensemble methods and parallel ensemble methods. So, sequential ensemble methods, where the base learners are generated sequentially, as its name implies, the base learners are generated sequentially. The basic motivation of sequential methods is to exploit the dependence between the base learners. Why the sequential methods are used? So that the base learners could have the dependency on each other. The overall performance can be boosted by weighing previously mislabeled examples with the higher weight. That is nothing but sequential ensemble methods. Whereas parallel ensemble methods are the methods where the base learners are generated in parallel. Both the name implies the same thing. In sequential, the base learners are generated sequentially, and in parallel ensemble methods, the base learners are generated parallelly. So the basic motivation of parallel methods is to exploit independence between the base learners, since the error can be reduced dramatically by averaging. So what we are doing, we are exploiting the independence between the base learners so that we can reduce the errors. Most ensemble methods generally use the single base learning algorithm to produce the homogeneous base learners, means learners of the same type, that is nothing but homogeneous base learners, so that homogeneous ensembles can be happened. There are also some methods that use heterogeneous learners, that is learners of different types, leading to heterogeneous ensembles. So homogeneous base learners are leading to homogeneous ensembles, and the methods that are used for heterogeneous learners, that is learners of different types, leading to heterogeneous ensembles. So in order for ensemble methods to be more accurate than any of its individual members, the base learners have to be as accurate as possible, because if the base learners will be as accurate as possible, then the accuracy can be achieved and the errors are overcome, and we are getting the proper output and proper ensembles. So these are the basics of ensemble methods, which are used for improving the predictions or for decreasing the variance. Basically, two methods are used, that is sequential ensemble methods and parallel ensemble methods. So in our next section, we will see what is this bagging, boosting, stacking. So in next section, we will first cover with the concept of bagging. Thank you.